how to do the jump roundhouse Van Damme kick on screen. If you guys ever seen the regular roundhouse from Van Damme, I'll link it in the description below. Watch that one first, otherwise you won't really get this one, because I'm not going to touch the entire topic of the first video. So he does it in a few different ways, not many, but a few different ways. One of the ways he does it is mostly from a low position here. And from here, he'll slowly do this jumping part, bring the arm up a little slow, and then the kick comes in fast afterwards. So he's kind of letting the audience know, look at me, I'm heavy, I'm strong, the kick is coming, and then you see the speed. So that's the trick behind Van Damme's movie kick. He'll do this, and then he'll go, right, a little bit like this. Ah, and then he kicks. Right, so he does it different than the real actual way of doing it, Taekwondo style, which is bending both knees. Bending both knees, you turn, and then you kick. That's the real Taekwondo that's doing the jump roundhouse. But the way that he does it is, so he looks better on screen, is you'll catch, instead of this angle here, you'll catch at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, this way. Only towards me, so this way, my left leg is a little bit closer to the camera. So he doesn't bend it all the way because you don't see the ground anyway, so it doesn't matter. And he leaves it to your imagination how high he's jumping. He's not jumping that high, you can't see the floor. So you'll bend the leg this way, because if not, this leg will look short and this leg will look long. So it's all about aesthetic, it's all about symmetry with Van Damme. He tries to make his legs look longer. So from here, you'll go down, knee will go that way towards the camera and not bend it, but here, and then he'll bring the kick all the way around. Okay, that said, he does sometimes bend the back leg, but when he bends the back leg, it's for the same reason, to make himself look like he's jumping higher. If you guys see the scene in Lionheart where he fights in the pool is like this, just like in Bloodsport. You guys see Bloodsport, the floor is like this, but at the end of the fight, the floor goes up. A lot of people don't think of this shit. It's like, that's how Van Damme makes his kicks look super high and jump super high, because he's jumping off a surface almost like this. So if I'm here, this is pretty much the trick behind the kick in the pool scene. Come back here now, bro. Come back over here, from behind. So if the guy, can you come here, Anna? You being this part or no? Are you right or not? So let's say the person's head is here, right? Which is the case in Lionheart. And in that kick, he does bend the knee. Because it's like that. If he doesn't bend the knee, his foot's gonna be like over here and the kick's gonna look low. So in that scene, he actually wants to make it look like he's jumping super high. Because the guy's head is right here. And Van Damme pretty much does this. So then, the thumbnail of that kick looks super high. But the truth is, he's using a trick. He's jumping from higher. It's the same thing with the Bloodsport. When he does the Van Damme kick on Bolo. Bolo is shorter than him, and on top of that, Van Damme is here and Bolo is here. So that's the trick behind making the kick look so high when in reality it's not. So if you know all these tricks, if you can even kick a little bit, you can sort of pull it off like Van Damme does. Because this kick in particular, the jump balance is not hard to do. Okay? Now, the third way that he does it, it's the same as the first one that I showed, but with a step. So instead of being here, he'll take a step first just to make himself look even heavier. Like for example, in that scene where he's in the squash area, he punches the guy backs up. To create distance, he does this. Right, it's just a little hop. You take a little hop forward, you make yourself think you're heavy, and then when you jump, then you're light. That's pretty much the trick behind it. And sometimes he'll turn all the way, of course, but still looking at the camera as long as possible. And then he'll turn. But that's pretty much it for the jump roundhouse Van Damme. It's not that complicated. It's all about the angle. Remember, the angle that he uses here is the angle, like when not the camera is here, but the angle he uses is down here. Right there. There he goes. That's pretty much the whole trick. And with the 360, the camera's all the way here. Put all the way down there. And you guys already know the 360 Van Damme. I already broke that one down. I'll link that one below too for you guys. But then from here, pretty much, he jumps. And then you do catch the floor. But the angle from the bottom will make the kick look much higher. Look, watch. You know what I mean? One more time. So this is the trick. It's all about the camera angle. It's all about how you look on screen. Remember, screen is not 3D, it's 2D. So It's you can pull off a lot of tricks, and most people won't catch it because they don't understand camera. That's it. See you in the next video, guys. Catch you later.
Bye!